Welcome back, and thank you for staying with us here on Daybreak. The time now is 6:21. It's Thursday morning, and we're getting a little artsy here. Yes, we are. I'm here with Chad Sorg. Thank you for coming on.
Thanks for having us.
We have some very cool stuff that we're going to be chatting about here. There's a new exhibit all the way down in Vegas. I don't know why you're going down there. That seems unnecessary to me. No, I'm joking. It's fun down there, the city of lights and excitement. But it's DADA Motel.
DADA Motel,
explain that.
Well, it was Jeff's idea, actually. Okay. It was a show that that we did last June. It was here in town. It was in the El Cortez Hotel, Cortez, downtown. We had about 60 artists of all disciplines, musicians, theater, and visual art. So this show is a selection of the visual art.
Yeah, and some really neat things that you have here. Let's go ahead and chat with a couple of the artists here. This is Tova, and this is Jeff. Thank you for coming on, you guys.
Thank you.
Oh, no problem. Now, Tova, tell me a little bit about what you do.
I really don't know. I take eggs and I torture them, is what I say. This is one with staples in it that nobody can see out in television land.
Can I hold it up for the
camera?
Okay. Absolutely. Let's see, Stuart, our cameraman. Let's see if we can get a close-up on this egg here. We're going to try to get it here. And these are tortured eggs.
Tortured eggs. Well, this is a second one with screws through it. It really just started out as an exercise in contrast.
That's just it. And what's the meaning behind the tortured eggs?
Oh, no meaning of any significance, really. No, just to reexamine the ways that you look at ordinary things. People have suggested before, why don't you use ostrich eggs, goose eggs? There's a very rich history of egg art. And so, no, I just want a regular chicken egg. I just want people to see what they're familiar with in a different way.
Yeah, very interesting. Okay, and Jeff, what do you work on?
I do neon art.
And we can hear it buzzing behind us here. It says bus on it. And this is very cool. And it's also a very interesting contrast that you have because it's the bright lights, the bright neon, but then you have this old beat up truck there as well.
Yep, that seems to say it all.
Yeah.
About Reno.
We like that. So how did you get into making something like this?
Oh, I lived in Winnemucca and I come down to Reno to learn how to do this. It was a pretty good spot to learn. There's plenty of it around.
Yeah, and there really is a lot of just art and a lot of cool things that are going on here.
There is. It's a busy little town.
And, you know, I think people don't always realize that Reno does have such a neat cultural history, and there is so much here. We often think of that in Las Vegas or places like that, but all of these artists are from right here.
I never think of Vegas and culture in the same sentence.
Yeah, I guess you might be. I guess maybe.
Yes, Reno has much more culture.
You caught me on that one. I'm thinking of the fine foods and the glitz and the glamour, but you're right. When it comes down to culture,
Reno's a pretty glitzy place.
Yeah, we like it here.
We wrote the book. They're just copying us.
Nice. Well, Chad, let's get you back over here. And real quick, let's sum up where this exhibit is going to be and everything. It is at the UNLV campus at the museum there.
Yeah, that's right. It's at the Marjorie Barrick Museum, which is natural history and culture. So they do have it.
They do have it's some right history there. Okay, great. And how long is this going to be going on for?
It's going to be up for 2 months.
Okay.
Yeah, starting on January 25th.
Okay, and if you want more details on the DADA Motel exhibit, you can just visit Hot Topics on our web channel, KOLOTV.com. Thank you so much for coming on.
All right, thanks for having us.
All righty, go check it out and stay with us. We'll be right back here on your Thursday morning edition of Daybreak.